It's almost like, what do you call it, soy burger or something.
Right, yeah, it is. It's soy. It's made out of soybean. And so when you, if you're going to get tofu, if you want to eat it every once in a while, make sure that it's non-GMO. Because it is, so corn and soy are the, like, and wheat, they're highly genetically modified.
Right.
And so make sure that the container says it says non-GMO. Locally, you can pay the same price and get local tofu too. There's a company here that makes tofu and some other soy products. So you can get local, it's fresher, and you know, it doesn't have a lot of, you shouldn't have a lot, it should have like maybe two or three ingredients, that's it. Just to kind of stabilize it so it doesn't be incurred. So in the Asian cooking cuisine, so Chinese restaurants, you know, you often find a bean curd dish for the vegetarian.
Yes,
but it's a bean curd. So it really is a bean. They're doing it now. Now I guess they're introducing other kinds of tofu, like, so there's like hemp, one made out of hemp.
Right.
People are doing it out of chickpeas. So there's different variations for folks. Because some people are allergic to soy.
Right.
You know, they can't have it. So there's other ways around it. And so for the spices, because again, without some spice, it's not going to taste like lunch at all. This is a spice blend that we produce and sell at the website. This is a chili lime. The chili and lime. I might use a black lime. Black lime and an aged lime, which is also good for digestion. And so I'm going to take about 2 tablespoons of the chili lime and put it right in the mix. And this mix is made up of blend of chili powder, the black lime, there's onions, garlic, there's turmeric in there. Turmeric is probably hear a lot about turmeric right now, anti-inflammatory, you know.
That's kind of, it tastes like hot.
Well, it's spicy. It's a little spice. So sometimes it's not really a heat kind of spice, but definitely to add some flavor.
Use too much of it, it's strong.
It can be, yes, absolutely. Let's create a nice little blend. And so you can do it either way. Put it in here, or you can just pour it over the tofu and so it marinates. And the longer stuff with anything else, the longer you let it sit to marinate. So usually if you do it overnight, you want to grill or something like that, put it on the griddle, that's ideal. So that's already going to change the way it looks.
Mm. That's flavorful too.
It has to be flavorful, or else you're not really going to enjoy it much. And so, Lana, is going to take some, and so we have a little bit of olive oil on the griddle. Okay. And we're going to take some, we're going to put on here and let that kind of. So that's been heating up for a while, because we got things that way to make it up.
It sounded clear, didn't
it? Why put them all on it? So it's not sizzle. And if you're into buying tofu extra firm, you're looking for texture, especially if you're just getting started with it, because when it's soft, you may not enjoy that quite as well, because the texture is a little bit to get used to. So extra firm. So good alternative to, you know, chicken sometimes, or any other kind of protein. So it gives us protein. That's really why a lot of vegetarians do eat it. It's a good protein.
I know, I've seen a lot of vegetarians, like substitute for, like a burger, to eat mushrooms.
Right, or bell mushrooms.
Or bell,
right,
yeah.
Yeah. So we do a lot of work with mushrooms, quite honestly. So it's not just pork, but bell is good in terms of like a meat substitute. Because it has that meaty texture.
Right.
And you can bread it. So I made cutlets out of it. You can bread it. You can do lots of creative things with it. But there's other mushrooms too that are really good for you. Shiitake is really good for you. Mushrooms are the only food, and they're not even a plant food, but you know, they're in their own kind of kingdom, that have vitamin D. So during the winter, because we're not out, we're not absorbing as much sunlight, it's a good food to eat during the winter months.
A lot of people get turned off on the mushroom on how it's grown.
Right.
Because there's a lot of fertilizer stuff around it.
Right, it's grown in that manner. But here it is, mushrooms actually, they're the largest living organisms. So there's something called the mycelium network underground.
Mm-hmm.
So where plants are growing, they can't grow without the help of mushrooms. So you could turn away mushrooms, but without those mushrooms, we wouldn't be growing food.
Mm-hmm.
So there's a network, so they say, you know, mushrooms have an underground network, much like we have the, internet. They have an internet on the ground. So if you ever get on Google, internet, you know, Google that mushroom mycelium network, and you'll see what comes up.
Okay.
And how special they are. There's a lot of good documentaries out right now, too. One long ago, talking about the value of mushrooms and what we're learning about them more and more. And they do go wild foraging them. So there's different varieties. One of our favorites is matake. Matake is another, it's called hen of the wood. Mm-hmm. Very meaty. Oyster mushrooms too. Make chowder out of it. So instead of like, you know, clams, mm-hmm. you use oyster mushrooms because they have texture and kind of flavor mm-hmm. Profile. Certain types of seaweed. Yep, let it go on the bottom. Yep. So that's going to move along with a pair of gloves and feel the saddle a little bit more. So you see how it's broken down quite a bit.
I grew some kale too.
Okay.
I grew kale about 2 years ago.
Okay.
And you grow fast and then just shoot off. And I was finally just like plucking some stalks off like every other day, bringing it home, rinsing it off. Remember I was telling you that? And I just sauteed up real fast and
fry. Right, you can cook it really fast.
Yeah, green onion, throw a little garlic in there. Mm-hmm. And I would sometimes just eat it like that.
Right, yeah. So it does saute really fast. And again, easier to find right now. So farmers markets around you. There's community gardens around you. But kale is like the go-to. And there are other greens, but a lot of kale going on right
here. Who charges you hard over here? You ever done any research on Dr. Sacred?
I have. Yeah, I'm familiar with his work. And the Alkaline down here. Okay. Yep, I'm familiar. I think his work is great, you know, in terms of him being able to help lead people on a path of, you know, kind of establishing their diet and eating cleaner. And he has a guy who's a mushroom advocate too. He puts up a list. Right, but there's certain foods that he doesn't have, like tofu is enough.
No, no.
Right, there's certain foods
no
that are
broccoli, not. No, right. Like carrots.
Right. Well, yeah, because it's like the alkaline, and then you go a little further in terms of hybrid, non-hybrid food pieces. So foods that you feel, you know, that as people of color we haven't been eating all our life.
I try to bring a lot of the herbs in.
Okay.
Wormwood, they butter.
Nice, yeah.
Now, what about cauliflower? Do you hear anything on cauliflower saying they don't have any nutritional value? Broccoli, they say broccoli does because of the grain in it, but most of our nutritional value is in fruits and vegetables that has color. And cauliflower don't have color at all.
Right.
So they would say they didn't have nutritional value. Do you hear anything on that?
I've heard both ends.
Okay.
That it doesn't, and then of course it's always information that says something.
Uh-huh.
So that it does have nutrients, I mean, that it has vitamin A, and you get some calcium from cauliflower.
Okay.
Now, it may not be as substantial as you would get from, you know, the greens and something, another particular vegetable, but it's all in moderation. So, you know, there's a big movement with cauliflower too right now.
Mm-hmm.
Cauliflower steaks are really big, have you tried that? You can make a steak out of cauliflower.
Wow.
So if you keep the head together,
right.
You slice it, and you can bake it, you can bread it.
Mm-hmm.
And so there's nutritional value. Now, it wouldn't be, doesn't need to replace anything.
It wouldn't be a high nutritional value.
Right, but I think it's a good food. It's a good plant food. And if you can get it, and anything you can get locally is even better. Because it's grown in the environment that you live in.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so it's more your body will recognize it in a different way than it would something that's grown, even if it's organic, in Washington State.
Right.
So getting food that's grown here is much better. Philly is a great place in terms of the local food.
Another thing I read up on was the waxy substance that they put on, that they spray on the fruit and stuff that be in the market, that gives it the eye appeal, because if you notice, it's always in the bright lights, the fruit is always shiny, and it's a waxy substance that's edible, but it's harmful. And they were saying what you should do is, what your fruit is, wash it off with baking soda. Did anybody hear that?
Yes.
Wash off the baking soda, sprinkle on that,
yes.
like with cheese. If you got cheese, it don't stick together. Mm-hmm. Cheese don't stick together. They don't spray it with something. You know what I'm saying? That wax, some of that wax and stuff.
Just like with McDonald's. Did you see the thing they done with McDonald's? It sat on the shelf for 6 months.
Oh, that burger? Oh, man.
And then you go back.
Listen, what of them
turned into like
wax. The burger didn't even burn when they put it on the grill.
Yeah.
What? It didn't even burn up.
It didn't
even
burn.
Yeah. The french fries be hard as pencils if you just let them sit.
Do you ever think why you can't heat up McDonald's food? Why they never the same after they get cold and you try to heat up McDonald's food? It's never the same.
Yeah, I know.
It's just because of whatever that stuff inside.
I mean, it don't ferment, it didn't go bad at all.
You're killing us, man.
I'll just get those burgers for $1 when I was 19. $1 burgers now, man.
Right, so if you have the questions, the cheaper, so they make you a research check for us, yeah. So we feel we're getting the deal. We're getting the deal because it's $1, $2.
$1.
Right, we feel like, oh wow.
Cheeseburgers and 19 points of fries.
We can do so much with, you know, that $1, but then we have to look at the quality of what we're doing.
Right.
You know, and what we're getting, that's really what's more important. So it's kind of, we have to be the ones to shift out on the mindset in terms of quality, not versus quantity. So it's better to eat something that's a good quality than something that we're getting a whole lot of, but not so good for us.
I think our problem is grandfather then. And what I mean by that is, we cook the way our mothers cook. Our mothers cook the way our grandmothers cook, and so on and so on. And when our great-grandparents cooked, they was cooking on saliva. You know what I mean? That's how they was eating the whole pig and the whole everything. And I wonder how diabetes and stuff was then compared to now. I think it's more prevalent now than it was then, I think. Because there's a lot of additives and stuff that they add to food and stuff now for mass production and stuff. Because, I don't know.
You know, about a year ago, I had high blood pressure.
Mm-hmm.
I had like 209 over. And ever since I stopped eating meat, my blood pressure's been fine.
That meat, that mucus and stuff. And that's the germ goes around the mucus. Mm-hmm. Anything that creates that mucus, that's what the germ latch onto. And meat makes mucus too at the same time.
But like it's not just dairy. Like you say, mucus is really the only thing.
Yeah.
So where is that?
I just want to be better and try to teach my family how to be better. That's all I'm saying.
So you know what I'm going to do? I'm not going to mix it in. I'm going to put it on top. That way, if you prefer not to have it, then you can have that. Okay, I'm going to spend that. Okay.
Extra cheese.
So I'm just going to add some sesame seeds into our salad. Yeah, but again, if you're gonna try extra firm, they cook it really well, you know, take your time with it, and that'll make a huge difference in terms of what the end result is. But you know, the point I want to add on to what you were saying about like meat and everything like that, because most of us grew up on meat, right? And it's different with what they're doing to it now versus when our grandparents and grandparents were eating meat.
Right.
They were raising their own animals to some degree. So there's a connection with the animal.
Was the dye and all that?
Things very different right now, where you have nitrate, so you like the processed meats, like sandwich meats are the worst.
Yes.
You know, the sauce, they put so many chemicals in that to add this flavor to make it shelf stable. And then we're living in a time where they're mass producing meat. The time that it takes an animal to raise an animal, they eat a lot of it. It takes time.
Right.
Under natural circumstances, it takes time. Now, they're producing chicken and cows, like it's on auto speed. You know, it really is. And that's not how nature had intended it. So if you want to eat meat, it's not so much the meat itself, but it's the processing and what they're doing to it. Because I also have my grandmother lives until about 110. They had everything. But they raised animals, they gardened, they farmed, and they didn't have the same diseases that young people have today.
Yeah,
little kids
that's
with diabetes. Yeah. That was unheard of 20 years ago.
That's what I'm saying.
When I was growing up, we didn't have, like, that wasn't real. Now that's very real.
I seen something on the chicken breast. They showed the chicken breast from the 60s compared to the chicken breast nowadays.
Right.
See, we think bigger is better all the time. Exactly. So, you know, the way they make the chicken breasts now, them joints about like this. But in the 60s, it was a normal size chicken breast, 4 ounces. 4 ounces is like a deck of cards. That's about 4 ounces. So a chicken breast was just a little bit bigger than that in the 60s compared to almost a 10-ounce chicken breast is now today.
Well, everything has been supersized.
Everything's supersized.
We want, it's like the mentality. We want more, so more bang for the buck. So they've conditioned us to want more bang for the buck. And so we'll sacrifice.
They got us thinking more is better.
More is better, but it's not necessarily the case. portions are really small.
Mm-hmm.
Right, so we'll complain when we go to the restaurant, so that's not enough food. But the portions, you know, they cost more, but what you're getting is more quality meal, and someone really likes to do this job, and they mm-hmm. really put some good energy in this food, and they're trying, they play it up really beautifully for you.
Right.
And so even like with fast food, like the picture that you see in an advertising, what you get in that box don't look the same.
No, sure. No.
They don't look the same, they can slap that thing together, right?
Mm-hmm.
Because someone's like, well, that's what you get for a dollar.
Yeah.
That's kind of like what it is at the end of the day. So it's kind of, we have to kind of take our power back in some ways. And a lot of the classes that we do is really focusing on like, well, how do you take the power back? It's in your kitchen.
Mm-hmm.
It's in your home. Mm-hmm. Your kitchen is your power center. And that's where your help is. So sometimes it's not even so much about what you put, it's how you put it. And then you do it. So that's something else that's changed from grandparents' generation to ours. People are not cooking as much.
Microwave.
So microwave is not cooking. You know, that's not cooking. So that's a huge difference between then and now.
It is. Instant everything. Everybody want instant. Say, bang, come on. I ain't got time. So that's it. 15
minutes. Everybody want food.
Whatever age. You see?
Everybody want food.
I'm guilty. Now you can.
I'm going to be from the whole thing. I'm going to try now.
The days of the family sitting at the dinner table was almost gone too. Remember the whole family sit down at 5 o'clock for their dinner?
Everybody
food the right way in there. Praise the food. I tell myself, y'all come on eat there. Why you hot?
So it's kind of reprioritizing what's really important. So at the end of the day, if we're focused on just work, which we have to sometimes, not at work, right? But we can't sacrifice the most important part of our life, which is really eating and family.
Right.
You know, so what we put in our bodies and who we share it with and who we prepare with, those are really some of the most important pieces that, you know, we have to get back to.
Yeah, because my children now, I have to stop them from bringing the, what you doing to the table, the iPhone, the iPad thing. I said, no, that ain't even dinner, they got the iPad thing right there, everybody. No, we're not doing that.
No. Oh, my son is one of the new.
Yeah. Now, that's why we can lose too.
I try to tell them,
hey, who's the new, who's got the waxy substance? Spray it on it too.
Okay.
Well, look it up. Yeah. Who's got to wax himself to spray on it as well?
That's why it costs 57 a pack and you get 6 of them.
That's what children need. Who's the new? Quick for them to eat.
Right, so quick. We're on like autopilot. We want to eat fast food. Mm-hmm. Because at home. So when we're eating at home, we're eating fast too.
Yeah.
And we just open up boxes and open up, you know, and those things are sugar, fat, salt. So that's, and so young people right now that have diabetes, you know, a lot of people, you know, well, you know, sugar can't, it used to be a treat, it's like a, you know, a special occasion, now it's an everyday thing. Everybody has a cookie, there's always an ice cream, and it's everywhere, so we're bombarded with everywhere around us, it's food. Every corner we turn, there's food, you know, which is, you know, good and bad, all right? So y'all can help yourselves here. And again, I won't be offended if you, you know, the tofu is not, you know,
right.
Something that you want to try, that's fine. If you try it, you don't like it, you try it, you love it, that's great.
Right. I want to look at that too.
You need to have the coffee, you know what I'm talking about.
Longer, if you go to cook for a long period of time, it's going to get firmer. Because all it is that's in there is water. It's the water that changes. So once you cook it, it's like cooking a piece of fish a long time, or a piece of meat, all the water gets pulled out of it, and the texture changes.
I mean, you can taste it. You have to taste it before. I mean, you have to taste it.
What was the name of the sweet beer again?
Agave.
I think that.
It's agave. Taste of lime.
Yeah, you taste of lime, yeah.
Now, I'm not a tomato eater unless it's cooked. Tomato sauce, ketchup,
you don't like it yet.
But I'm eating raw right now.
That's good.
Juneteenth. I dated slaves, free slaves.
They have to read.
Yes.
Now, Marcus.
Yes.
So, Marcus.
Yes.
Lincoln knew that the North was going to have more power economically because the slaves that were freed from the South was willing to work for free in the North. Not in the South.
Right.
So you got your textiles and so on. Whatever state, whatever the economical textiles was going to grow stronger of the slaves leaving the South going to the North. Because for real, if it was left up to Lincoln,
no.
He would have signed the paper.
And they had the skills also.
Yeah. All that. We invented everything.
That's how
the union started.
That's how the union
started. We invented the broom. We invented the dustpan. We've been anything that you can name. I got a big old sheet, almost about half the size of that door. Everything that we invented by who in a year. But by us not having money or anything, the powers that be were off us for $500, and they make trillions off it right now. The war invented the heart transplant machine, and he needed the blood transplant machine. We needed a blood transplant, they wouldn't get it to him. We invented stop sign, steam engine, we invented everything. License plate to the front. Look at him, man. Here, this is my partner right here. This is Mr. Youssef. This is him right here.
The parts for guns, parts.
Oh, yeah.
They put it together, but we created the part.
Hey, this is good. I wasn't hungry, but it was good. Some people when they used stuff good, it was on. That was good.
Something
I never had. Yeah, it's good. It's sprinkled for good. Me neither. Why ain't a couple of them?
Pempamsie Media. I will be back with